सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् ज्ञानसम्बन्धाचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Today is the, as per the solar calendar, new month in the Vedic tradition. So from today, the Indian villages in Bengal, in UP, in many of the Indian states, even in Madhya Pradesh, all the states which follow the solar calendar, all those states, this whole month, they will drink neem juice and the cleaning the stomach. They will live on liquid diet. And our Niragara Samyama is matching with it. We have not planned, automatically it has happened. All the states which follow the solar calendar. See, Andhra and Karnataka follow lunar calendar. Tamil Nadu, Kerala, UP, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, Gujarat, all these states follow solar calendar. So as per the solar calendar, today is the new month beginning. In the whole 12 months, this one month they will be with a liquid diet. It's almost like a Ramzan. From this tradition only they started the Ramzan. Ramzan was almost, one thing in Ramzan is they eat after sunset. Here they don't eat even after sunset. The whole month they live on liquid diet, drinking neem juice in the morning. They worship mother. The whole West Bengal, this is the only month they eat less sweet because they don't eat. Indian villages, these traditions were there. I don't know whether now in the cities it is not there. But still in the Indian villages, these 5-6 states which follows the solar calendar, they all do this observation. They go to that local deity of the village. So this is the offering given to the deities. Let's start the satsang.
The first question today is from Eilet Shimron, IA number 10, who's asking, how does one stay faithful to his or her religion, assuming they feel a deep connection and find truth in their religion, while currently maintaining a connection with the Guru? I will say a prayer in Hebrew before bed and then chant for the morning puja. Is there a contradiction here? Does the subtle sense of guilt only exist in the mind?
Eilet Shimron, don't worry, there is no such thing as contradiction. Have everything. You will see automatically whatever needs to be dropped by itself. See, there should not be conversion. Conversion is a violence. I wanted to tell you all, religious conversion is violence. Never ever anybody in my sampradaya will practice religious conversion. No. No conversion. In transformation, you never have pain. Suddenly you will see some of your old faith and beliefs have completely left you due to your new discovery. Then it is not conversion, it is transformation. So after transformation, you may not choose legally to adopt that new religion you discovered. Please understand, this is a very subtle issue. This has to be handled with a lot of sensitivity, because I see so much of psychological violence, cultural invasion. As an Indian born and brought up in a village, I know the sufferings of religious conversion. our poverty is being exploited for the sake of bread and butter. People converting to a different religion. I have seen villages getting converted. I have seen the cultural invasion happening and the psychological violence being done. So I tell you, as a sufferer, victim of religious conversion, with tremendous sensitivity and love and compassion for humanity, I make this as a law for Nityananda Sampradaya and all my devotees and disciples. Thou shall not convert. We will only spread, radiate transformation. Understand, I can tell you millions of stories, painful stories, where conversion is nothing to do with religion, it is more to do with politics. It became a power-centric action, not spiritual-centric action. I tell you a small example. I used to have a Shiva deity from the young age, maybe from the age of 8, 9 till 22. And after I realized my avataric mission, I stopped doing morning puja. I used to worship with a small deity which I used to carry wherever I go. Now, after I became the successor of Madhuri Adhinam, I have to start my everyday morning with the worship. So from the Madhuri Adhinam, I have been given a Shivalinga. Which is a hereditary, traditional. Even to shift from my old Shivalinga to new Shivalinga, it was such a big difficult. I tell you, when you relate and live with the deity, that deity has become part of your space, inner space. So now, if you see, I'll keep both Shivalingas. I'm not able to give up that old one for an incarnation. After realizing incarnationhood, it is not change from one sampradaya to another sampradaya. It is change of one deity to another deity. Both are representation of same Shiva. Because religion is your love affair. Understand? It is such a personal, sweet experience. I know among my own devotees who consider me as the mother, they do not want to see the masculine Kalbhairava form. And some of my own disciples who connect with me more like Kalbhairava do not want to see the Meenakshi Bhava Darshan. Religion is personal experience. It is deeper than any love or any love affair. Love affairs are only between minds, but religion is between consciousness. The very being. I tell you, if you forcibly ask somebody to eat certain food, change their dress, it is physical violence. If you forcibly ask somebody to think in certain pattern, it is mental violence. without making the other person understand, if you pass any law and force it on the people, it is emotional violence. Religious conversion is conscious violence, most powerful violence on the planet Earth. That is why all consciousness based religions, Vedic tradition, Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, Sufism, none of us believe in conversion. It is my vision. One day I'll surely gather all these traditions which does not believe in conversion. Even Greek Orthodox Church does not believe in conversion. The traditions which does not believe in conversion, we will all gather together and declare to the whole humanity, no conversion, only transformation as a law. Let us not be violent to the human civilization. There is enough of people who are violent to human civilization, who are greedy of money. Money mongers keep humanity in poverty. Power mongers, politicians keep humanity in fear. There are so many groups, vested interest groups, vomiting enough of venom and violence on humanity. We religious leaders, the spiritual leaders, should stop this concept of conversion. People ask me, Swamiji, you are the successor of Madurai Adhinam, great saint who revived Madurai Adhinam, he himself converted people from Jainism and killed thousands of monks. I wanted to make it very clear, I do not believe this story. First thing, he only transformed the king, Pandya king. Whoever had the transformation followed him. Second, such a loving person like Jnana Sambandar can never afford to kill people. Maybe it's a later interpolation. I don't think there would have been any violence or killing in Tirunjana Sambandar's life. Such a great saint can't afford to kill people. Surely he wouldn't have done. And if it was true, I can't even say if it was true. I know. I have seen the inner space of Tirunjana Sambandar. I live in that inner space. Jnana Sambandar can't afford to kill people. Such a great saint. Maybe some of these Jain monks have committed suicide by themselves or ran away. Anyhow, now I am making it very clear. For my sampradaya, only transformation, no conversion. Let me make it very clear. When the transformation happens, you discover the new religion. It is not preached to you. You discover it. So we will only help people to discover the Vedic tradition. That is why in Hindu tradition there is no conversion. We will help people to discover Vedic tradition. So I let Shimron, I am only supporting you to discover. So do not have any conflict. Have both hand in hand and enjoy best things. No need to carry guilt. At some time, what is more useful for you will stand with you, and what is not will automatically merge into the other one. Your Hebrew prayer may merge simply into the morning chanting, or your morning chanting may merge simply into the Hebrew prayer. And even if they don't merge and they are standing individually and supporting you, perfectly all right. Nothing wrong. What is wrong? Nothing is wrong. And I tell you very clearly, I have so much of love for Buddha and Mahavira, so many masters, even Islam masters, Sufi masters. I have so much of love and respect for all of them. I read many of their books, not just to come and blabber and repeat in the discourses, no. As my personal enjoyment. Personally, I enjoy their words, their life, their teachings, their expressions. So many Christian masters have contributed to me. Thomas Kempis, Saint Francis of Assisi. Still, I have so much of love for Saint Francis of Assisi and Thomas Kempis. There is a beautiful book, Practicing the Presence of God by Brother Lawrence. I tell you, I would have read that book at least 50 times. The Imitation of Christ, that is by Thomas Kempis. But both the books I used to read, even The Imitation of Christ. Both books have given me a lot of inspiration and encouragement. And same way, the letters of Saint Francis of Assisi. The book title is Go Forward. There are two books. One more book, Go Forward, by a sadhu of Ramakrishna order, Swami Premeshananda, his letters. They also give the same title, Go Forward. And the Saint Francis of Assisi, his compilation of his letters, is also called Go Forward. That was the book I always used to keep next to my bed and read. I have been inspired, encouraged by many spiritual religious leaders, masters, from all traditions, let it be on record. Let the history not be distorted or changed by my next generation disciples because of their vested interest to promote the Vedic tradition. I stand for Vedic tradition. I stand with Vedic tradition. I stand by Vedic tradition, no doubt. But I wanted this to be on record. I was also helped, supported, inspired, encouraged by many religious and spiritual leaders from many other traditions. So I tell you, no conversion, only transformation. Support human beings to discover whatever you discovered, whatever you experienced. One of the biggest problem India is facing is religious conversion and persecution of the majorities. Yesterday, Supreme Court has taken suo motu cognizance of 78 pilgrims dying in Amarnath within few days of the pilgrim path opened. Last year, the whole year, the whole season of pilgrimage, only 82 people died. This year, already 78 people within few days. Supreme Court has taken a suo motu cognizance and they asked the central government and state government of Jammu Kashmir and Amarnath Ji Shrine Board, the authorities, to come and explain. Death toll is actually 83, not 82, sorry, 83. Media reports are saying these guys don't even bother to create basic amenities. China seems to be much better in taking care of Kailash Yatris than Jammu Kashmir government taking care of Amarnath Yatris, because they provide more facilities and safe trip. Even Kailash, so many people don't die. Such beautiful infrastructure is created. I am taking pilgrims, yatris to Kailash, but I am afraid to take people to Amarnath. Still, I have not taken people to Amarnath, which is inside India. These guys don't care. Hindus need to tell, we are international minorities. See, now it is time, whole world is one country. So we will have to again and again remind the world, we are international minorities. Being persecuted everywhere, unattended everywhere. Come on, there is so much of money. Hindus pour for the religious traditions and religious rituals. Just my native town temple, Arunachala temple, that income is more than enough to make a 4-lane road to Amarnath. 1 year income is enough. But every state, it's really painful to see so many pilgrims dying in Amarnath, and Supreme Court has to take suo motu cognizance to save the pilgrims. I have immediately donated 10 lakh rupees to Hindu helpline to save Amarnath Yatris. As our humble contribution, VHP has taken up the job of setting up a private Hindu helpline to save the lives of the pilgrims, and we are also going to give more. We will be continuously giving more money. Of course, I am not going to touch the money which I allotted to Kailash. That is only for Kailash Nath. But there is so much money. We Hindus are very religious people. There is so much money sitting on our in our hand to promote our tradition and to support the people who are practicing our tradition. It's much worse than China government. I was shocked when China government did not accept. Of course, they have their own procedures. They do not want to accept any donations from outside or doctors from outside. But what about Amarnath? Why can't they just save the lives of the people who go to this Amarnath temple? People have to become aware, whatever religion they may be, but these basic things should be provided for every person who takes up the religious pilgrimage. Maybe when I come back from Kailash, I may go and stay in Amarnath for a week just to do social service. Not as an organized trip, just to do social service, to take care of people and give medical help and medical support, and really wanted to go and take care of the Amarnath Yatris. And I also tell you guys, from next year I will surely take you guys to Amarnath. We will go to Amarnath also. We will go to Kailash and Amarnath also, because I wanted to make sure that we put our effort to support the Yatris of Amarnath. ₹83 people dying in cardiac arrest, or I can say safely allowed to die, made to die, that's the right word I'll use, allowed to die and made to die, should not have happened. Anyhow, I started with religious conversion and went all around up to Amarnath and came back. All right, let's have just Amarnath ji darshan. We have come all the way. This is his cave where he sits in tapas. Can you show the Amarnath ji? These are small deities worshipped there. Yes, now you can see Mahadeva. Great. Anyhow, so Ayelet, Shimron, don't bother. Have both, enjoy both. After all, religions are, spiritual traditions are created for you to grow and transform yourself. Next question.
The next question is from Ma Sujata from Chennai, who is asking, Nityananda Swamiji, in yesterday's satsang, you spoke about the extraordinary characterization and truthful representation of characters in the serial Devon Ke Dev Mahadev. Can you speak more about this, Swamiji? Also, whatever is shown in the serial, how much of it is philosophically true?
It's a nice question. The question is, in yesterday's satsang, you spoke about the extraordinary characterization and truthful representation of characters in the serial Devon Ki Dev. Can you speak more about this, Swamiji? Also, whatever is shown in the serial, how much of it is philosophically true? Please understand, bringing a mythological story to life is not a joke. If I put all my intelligence, philosophical strength, understanding, all my abilities and try to do a serial on Shiva, it will not be better than Devon Ki Dev, I tell you. They are doing best job. It's amazing job they are doing. There are a lot of subtle points when Devi assumes human body. What happens? There are so many subtle points, philosophical points. They are presenting so beautifully. They are neither missing the philosophical thread nor missing the storyline and making it so alive. And I tell you, in ISKCON, they give you so many movies related to Krishna with English. Subtitles. I tell you, all our devotees should watch Devon Ki Dev with English subtitles. It's the best thing they are doing to the whole Vedic tradition. See, they are able to make the whole thing alive in front of you. And even those people who are acting, they have put so much of effort into the whole thing to present, to be honest and truthful to the original tradition. See, one of the worst thing happened to the Hindu mythologies, even the word mythology is wrong. Hindu Puranas is, it was understood by the Western angle, through the Western historians' eyes. Constantly we are being disrespected, abused, blamed, saying they don't have a meaning, they are just fantasies and all that. Max Muller translated Upanishads just to prove there is nothing in Upanishads. He writes in his letter, but till 90s, all our Indology scholars in India are all nothing but followers of Max Muller's. It is just last 10 years a new awakening has happened when the Sanskrit knowledge has started spreading all over the world. We were awakened to the truth. Max Mullerians cannot represent the Vedic tradition to its truth, in true form, with true respect. I tell you, Devon Ki Dev is a ripple effect of that awakening. A Purana is beautifully presented. Purana is the history written with the philosophical explanations. History with the philosophical footnotes is Purana. So, Devon Ki Dev people, the producers and directors and story writers, the whole team is really true to the concept of Purana. Purana is not just history. Purana is history with the understanding of philosophy. Incidents recorded with the big picture of philosophical understanding. With the understanding of the big picture, when incidents are recorded, that is called Purana. If the facts are recorded like everyday newspaper, it is called history. We Indians know only how to write Puranas. We are not newspaper guys. Devan ki Dev is really doing honest and true service to the Vedic tradition. I don't see even a trace of Max Müllerianism in Devan ki Dev. They are truly, honestly reviving. Especially the people who are supporting their philosophy team, Devdutt Bhattnayak, what a beautiful job they are doing. I wanted to specially mention his name, Devdutt Bhattnayak, for doing amazing research and supporting. The whole serial is presented in such a beautiful way. All the concepts of an incarnation, why even an incarnation needs tapas, everything is so beautifully presented to a common man. So many questions you guys ask me. Swamiji, you are an incarnation. Why did you do it to do tapas? Parvati is an incarnation. She is doing tapas. All these difficult questions, they are presenting it so beautifully to the whole mass. That is the beauty. Visually, they are able to present. And I recommend everybody to enjoy it.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer, a Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being benefiting thousands, a living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974220311. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.